Welcome to Morehead tonight. Oh, it's gonna be so scary and spooky and what's some other words? You're gonna be sad when you watch it. I don't really have anything else planned. I mean, I brought the mask. I thought, you know, maybe the rest would write itself, but I guess we'll find out on this episode. The theme is obviously Arbor Day. So we will. I'm kidding. It's not Arbor Day. It's Halloween. So we're gonna talk about it on Morehead tonight. Coming up right now. Welcome to Morehead tonight. Come here, get in tight. Actually, don't get in tight. Stay right there. Welcome to, as you saw at the beginning of the show, I'm off my medication, so this will be a good episode. The theme is Halloween, because it's, you know, almost Halloween. So that's why we decided on this theme. I love Halloween. I know that makes me unique. Most people don't like Halloween, but I love Halloween. You know, there's like candy and scary movies. I like dressing up, though. Obviously, at the front of the show, you saw me with my Leatherface mask on. Or, no, I'm sorry. Scary man mask, copyright reasons. I love dressing up. I love the costume part of Halloween. It's my favorite part. And I think I know why. I think it's because I grew up as a huge pro wrestling nerd ever since I was a kid. And I think just seeing them, you know, in their costumes and all these different things, you know, I mean, when I was a little kid, there was a man called The Undertaker, and he murdered people. I mean, kind of. I mean, put them in body bags and like in coffins and stuff. I assume they died of like, you know, suffocation, things like that. We don't know. They could have survived. There are all sorts of crazy characters. You had a guy named the Berserker who dressed up like a Viking and said huss a lot. I don't know what that meant. It might have been some sort of ethnic slur. But we had, oh my goodness, all sorts of different people, all that struck fear into the hearts of man, like, you know, the Mountie, who was a Canadian Mountie. Because when you think of scary, you think of Canadians. They're the scariest among us. Maybe not. These would be funnier if we had a... Go, please, audience, please settle down. I love using that stock footage, and I'm going to keep using it because it's free, and I can, and we have no budget. But no, I do. I love Halloween because of characters. Characters is what makes Halloween work. It's the same thing that makes pro wrestling work, right? You had characters. I mentioned The Undertaker. You had Jake the Snake Roberts, who would throw snakes on people. You know, that's scary. You had... Brutus the Barber Beefcake, who, I don't know, would cut people's hair incorrectly in ways that they didn't want their hair to be cut. I don't know. That was probably not the highlight of wrestling. But, you know, there were some other scary ones. You know, you had Abdul the Butcher. He had hepatitis. That was always scary. Who else? There was a guy named New Jack. He murdered people. Oh, gosh, I could go on and on. You know who was the best? This is, bar none, my favorite of all the wrestlers that have ever existed. And I don't even know if they were on TV or not. There was a guy named Jim Herd. He owned a bunch of Pizza Huts, and so they let him run wrestling because that makes sense. And he came up with a tag team called the Hunchbacks. And the gimmick was that because they had the hunch on their back, they couldn't be pinned and therefore would remain undefeated forever. And I love that because, really, when it comes down to creating characters, you want characters that can grow in no way whatsoever. Kind of like how this show grows in no way whatsoever. It's the same thing every week. I come out here and no one laughs and it's sad. And I cry the whole way home. All right, I have an hour drive and it's just tears the whole time. But anyway, we have a great show for you lined up today. We have, I've heard there's going to be a scary ghost here. I don't know what that means, but we'll find out. MSU student and Convergent Media major Alyssa Thomas is going to be here, going to talk about cosplay. I've been told that has nothing to do with Bill Cosby, so we're good there. And all other sorts of fun stuff, I guess. So we're going to take a break, and we'll be right back with all that after this. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Morehead Tonight. This is different. Joining me right now, my guest, a scary ghost. Ooh. So, scary ghost.
It's Ghost Man.
Ghost Man, of course. You prefer Ghost Man or Mr. Man?
You may have heard of me from many classics like Casper, Scooby-Doo. I've appeared in several times, made many cameos in that. I would love to show you my demo reel, if you will.
Your demo reel? I think you haven't taken your demo reel.
It's very hard to speak in the human realm for us ghosts, but I'm doing the best I can. Ooh.
So you have, I'm assuming you have some sort of reel that you would like to show us.
Yes, I have a new movie coming out about my life. It's called Ghost Man. It's amazing.
I love the title.
You should check it out. I think we have a clip for it, actually. I brought it to you on my ghostly, spooky hard drive. You should show that right now.
Hello? Is anyone there?
What's up, man?
Stuck in my head, you fiend!
Aha!
Where are you?
Surprise!
I don't know, I'm here.
All right, Chaz, take the sheet off.
What?
You can take the sheet off. This is...
No, I'm not Chaz, I'm Ghost Man.
Of course you're Ghost Man. First off, I would know that work from anywhere, all right? Clearly your work, all right? This is like the third time you've tried to get something on the air here at Morehead.
Why you always gotta hate, man? Like, why you always gotta cut that crap?
Ugh. Hey, is Michaela okay? Why was she in that? All right, if Alyssa hasn't left, we're gonna come back and have our special guest cosplayer, Alyssa Thomas, right after the break here on Morehead Tonight. Let the sheet.
Want to lose weight but don't know where to start? The first step is simple, get active. Take a stroll from your dorm down to the Fuzzy Duck for about a 1 mile round trip. You can take it a step further and start cooking some healthy food, but walk to IGA instead of driving to Kroger. That's about a mile and a half. And when you want to reward yourself for making progress, a trip to the movies is a 3 mile round trip. Once walking gets too easy, you can always start jogging. Happy exercising!
Welcome back to Morehead Tonight, continuing our Halloween episode. It's scary, it's everywhere, it's lightning. I don't know, lightning's scary. Joining us right now is Morehead State student Alyssa Thomas, here to talk about cosplay. It's Halloween, it's the perfect time, I think, to talk about dressing up and all that good stuff. So before we get started, tell us, what is cosplay, for those who don't know?
Well, cosplay is when you just dress up like a fictional character. To me, yeah, I put my own spin on it, and it's a lot of fun. I'm dressed as the Joker right now. like a nice little feminine Joker. Mm-hmm. And I go to a lot of conventions, so I see a lot of different styles of cosplay, and it's just really fun.
Right now, I'm actually cosplaying, if we could get a shot. I'm cosplaying as an adult right now. That's what I look like. It's pretty convincing, I think, that in my onset adult diabetes. But that's not true. I don't have that. That's very offensive to people who do have it. But we'll continue. So how did you get interested? You talk about going to convention stuff. How did you get interested in cosplay to begin with?
Yes, I don't cosplay myself a lot, but I see a lot of cosplayers. I went to two Lexington Comic-Cons now. And my favorite one to see is Pennywise the Clown. And I've gone to a Walker Stalker convention where people dress up like, obviously, zombies. And I've seen really nice Rick Grime cosplayers. It's really cool to see. A lot of teenage girls dress up like Carl from The Walking Dead. That's very interesting. So yeah, I go to a lot of different nerd conventions is what I call it now.
At these conventions, how does it work? I mean, are there competitions? I don't know a lot about cosplay, but yeah. Are there competitions about people trying to like outdress one another or?
Yeah, I actually, there was a little boy that was like 3 that cosplays as Daryl Dixon from Walking Dead. And he actually charges people to get pictures with him. So like if you're really good at cosplaying or really cute, because you know 3-year-olds are genuinely cute. Right. So, if you're good at it, I mean, you can make money off of it just looking like a celebrity or an anime character.
That's not a bad deal. You know, Walking Dead's ratings are down. I feel like if they replace, you know, Rick Grimes is leaving. If they replace him with a 3-year-old,
ratings through the roof.
Actually, if they replace this show, the host, with a 3-year-old.
Oh yeah.
I think the crew would prefer it. Easier to deal with, all that sort of thing.
It would definitely be interesting to see, honestly.
Now, one of the big things about cosplay is that there's a big like DIY, do-it-yourself feel to cosplay. What is, like, in terms of price or cost, I mean, how expensive do some of these kind of roles get?
I've looked up cosplay costumes, like genuine, faux leather, whatever, you do just genuine costumes, and it's like thousands of dollars. It can get expensive. I have a crazy wardrobe, though. So, like I said, I put my own twist on it, and I'm just like, this is me. Yeah. I have green hair. This is my natural hair, by the way. So, you know, it doesn't cost a lot if you just kind of just have fun with it.
Right.
But if you're wanting to be a professional cosplayer, which they have professional cosplayers that charge out the butt to, you know, see, like, you know, you go to Comic-Cons and you see Mark Hamill, and then you can also pay to see a stormtrooper, you know, like just a genuine stormtrooper. So it's crazy how much some people pay for cosplay outfits.
So I guess it just depends on
kind
of how intense you want to
go with it. Yes, how intense
you
want to
get with
it.
And I guess making money, I mean, you know, if you're making money, you can put a lot of money
into
it.
Yeah, yeah, and I feel like that's what a lot of people do.
I'm going to start cosplaying as Bob Ross. Is there a Bob Ross cosplayer? Because I feel like all I need is just to poof my hair up a little bit. Like, I already got the beard. I have no artistic abilities. That might stop me there, but
you can hire a makeup artist. You know, if you're going to make money off this, just hire, you know, makeup artists. And
what is the, we're going to wrap up here, but what is the best cosplay you've seen?
Like I said, I love seeing Pennywise, but I'm biased because I just love it. I love the movie It. But my favorite of all time now that I've seen was at Walker Stalker, Tennessee. Mm-hmm. It was Rick Grimes. This guy looks just like Andrew Lincoln, who is the actor who plays Rick Grimes. It's creepy, actually. Like, I thought it was him just messing with his fans. So, yeah, definitely him. And I follow him on Instagram. I think his name's the Everyday Grimes. So, shout out to him. He's really cool.
Now, before we leave, if you could cosplay as one person, ultimate cosplay, you'd have all the resources to do it, who would you cosplay as? I think I might know your answer, because you've mentioned Pennywise a couple of times. But
I don't know. I think I would go with Yoda.
There you go.
If I could get prosthetics and just everything going,
that
I'd
works
be Yoda.
For me. Now, we have this this weird tradition when we end interviews, and so far we haven't been thrown off the air for it yet. But if you would like to touch my monkey to end the interview, you have my permission to do so.
Awesome.
And we will throw to break.
Okay.
There we go. Alyssa Thomas, everybody. We will be right back to close up shop on Morehead Tonight right after this.
Hi, I'm Jay Morgan, president of Morehead State University. You're watching MSU TV.
Okay, we have made it the end of yet another episode. Oh, please don't cry. I know we're halfway through the season, and you all are going to be very sad when this is over. I can tell by the looks in all of your all's eyes. And by all of you, I mean no one, because I'm here by myself. That's not true. How would the camera zoomed in? We don't know. So, what did we learn on today's episode? Well, we learned that The Walking Dead would be a lot better if there were babies on it. As main characters. I mean, I know there's been babies. We also learned that Chaz Jenkins, not a good ghost. Let's just be honest about it. And we also learned that three episodes in, and no one has ever questioned why this microphone is on my desk with no cord. Doesn't do a thing. It's all just made up. It's fake. It's like my beard. None of it's real. I'm actually not even really a student here at Morehead State. I just showed up one day and said, hey, can I have a show? They didn't check credentials or anything. Very lax here. Very lax. What time is it? It's about that time. So, again, we never really learn anything. I like the way I look right now. I look like I'm almost a grown-up. And I like that, even with my little tie. We're going to take a little short goodbye here until next time. We will see you whenever that time comes. And remember, until next time, make good decisions. We'll see you.
Yo, I ain't here for the money, I ain't here for the fame. Though it might be nice to own a jet plane, I'ma do it all for you. Come along and see it's true.